Hello, this is a quick tip for Illustrator 27.9, which has arrived yesterday. And maybe you have already installed it or Creative Cloud has done that for you. So it has this new feature called Contextual Task Bar, which you may already have seen in Photoshop and also in Illustrator on the iPad, which has a task bar as well. So what does that mean? So when you have an object, and you see it's not there yet, but when you now switch to the selection tool, boom, there it is, the contextual taskbar. And it has some functions that you might want to use with this object. And contextual means these functions are different depending on the type of object. So with this one here, you can make a repeat in it. And you see, you've already get a menu, and then you can select the type of repeat. And this is what it does. But then when you select it, no more taskbar, because it's not there with every object yet. So let's just undo this so we get it again. And then you can also lock that object. Let's just do it. And you see again, the taskbar is gone because we cannot select this object. But I have set up a preference setting that we can, and there's the unlock symbol. And if I click on it, there's the taskbar again. So if you want to have this feature to unlock objects on the artboard, let's take a look. You need to open the preferences. I'm going to use the shortcut, which is Command K or Control K on Windows. And then you go to Selection and Anchor Display, and there it is. This is the setting which allows you to unlock objects on the canvas. So let's cancel that. And let's take a look at the taskbar again. So what else can you do with it? You can duplicate that object. And this doesn't show, but you will see it when you now move this thing. Now, when you now think, okay, let's transform again. I'm going to use the shortcut, which is Command D or Control D on Windows. But this doesn't make another copy because the first copy didn't get, you know, kind of recorded for this. So you still have to press the Alt key and move it and then do this if you want to transform again. Let's take a look at another type of object. I'm going to create a text object. And there you see, even if we have the text tool still active, we can already select a font from the menu, which is quite handy, and then also set up the text size. And another type of object. So I'm going to select this. These are more than one object, so you see it's mixed. And we can do quite different things with it. We can group them here, just group them, and we can also recolor them. And you see there it opens the recolor panel. Another object type where the contextual menu bar is working are linked images. So let's take a look at that. Going to select it, and you see you can do a couple of actions on it. You can edit that image. It's still linked. You see it by that cross. You can also open the links panel to check out all your links. You can apply a mask to it, and you can image trace it. This only triggers the initial image trace, so you still now have to open the image trace panel if you want to adjust this. So I'm going to go out of there. Also, I'm going back to this one here. When you go to Edit Path, it selects the direct selection tool for you. And again, the taskbar is gone. So let's go back to the selection tool. It also has a menu. And you see, you can show the properties panel here. In case it's not shown, you might not have it turned on continuously, so you can show it here. And you can also, so maybe you don't like that panel at all, so you can hide that. And then it's hidden. And maybe you want to use it again, then go to Window and Contextual Taskbar, and there it is again. Also, you can go here and reset its position, because when you grab it here, you can move it around like so. And when you now select it, you see it's up there and with the text as well. So maybe you want to reset it so that it's really beside your selected object, because only then it's really useful. So that's what you can do with the new feature Contextual Taskbar in Illustrator 27.9.